It is Tyr here, and I am here to talk about my thoughts about episode 17 of Big Brother season 26. And in this episode, it was the veto competition, Tucker's the head of household, and all right, let's get into this. So I'm honestly still so heated over this. I think it's really, really crappy that Brooklyn ate Angela's charcuterie board. And this is something that I've actually talked more than once to my sister about. I talked to my husband about it, who doesn't even watch the show, and explained it to him. And all of us agree that it was a really, really selfish thing to do. Brooklyn knew exactly what she was doing. Her excuse that you can't let good meat go to waste and that you have to eat it or it's going to go bad is not even accurate. I even looked this up just to be sure, but charcuterie board, like, that's essentially just lunch meat, like fancy lunch meat. And I've had lunch meat before, and lunch meat in my fridge, when it's been opened and is being opened and used, lasts for 3 to 4 weeks, sometimes more if you're lucky. So it lasts for a while. And you know, this charcuterie board was sealed. It hadn't been opened yet. I'm not 100% sure what kind of meats were in there. I think I saw salami or some kind of salami, or something like that. And it had only been around for a week that we know of. I mean, I don't know when it was, like, you know, created and put into stores, but a week that we know of. So it is week two, and Angela lost, or was first out of the head of household competition, so she's a have-not, which is, but side note, something that they haven't really, like, talked about or really shown all that much this season. It's just, like, it exists. Like, nobody really talks about it, which is weird. But anyway, so Angela's a have-not, so she can't eat her charcuterie board, so she put it in the fridge so that she could save it to eat later, like, when she's not a have-not anymore. And Brooklyn gets into it and just eats the whole damn, the whole thing, and uses the excuse, well, it's gonna go bad. No, it's not. It would last probably up to a month if you didn't open it. Those things sit on the shelf life for a decent amount of time before somebody even buys them. And Angela even said, I mean, in the diary room, but she said, I would be happy to share it. But she didn't ask. Brooklyn didn't ask. She just got into it. And let me tell you something. Brooklyn, it's very, you know, I don't know this for fact, but I've made observations. I saw the way she was introduced before the season officially began. She does not seem like she's struggling for money, so she knows charcuterie boards. She's had charcuterie boards before. She knew exactly what she was doing, and she knows that they can last up to a month if you don't open them, okay? So she knew exactly what she was doing. And, you know, I honestly, all my feelings for Angela aside, the things that she did in the beginning of the game, I mean, I still don't respect her for it, and I don't want to see her win because I don't think she deserves to win. But I felt it in my soul when she was crying. I would be upset too. I would be extremely upset. I would fight for it, and I would go up and I'd probably yank it out of her hands and be like, don't touch my food, because essentially this was a gift to Angela as a reward for becoming head of household, for winning the head of household competition. Right? So it was a gift for her. So it belongs to Angela, and Brooklyn just got into her food. Like, this is if you live in a shared household with, like, roommates, this is a crime against humanity. You don't eat someone else's food. This food did not belong to Brooklyn. She had no rights to it. And I know other people were getting into it too. I don't remember who it was, but, and they're just as guilty in my honest opinion, but the number one criminal here is Brooklyn, who opened it up. Did Angela deserve it? I usually do these on live so I can download them and just post them as videos later. But I did just get a comment. Did Angela deserve it? I don't think she did. You know, all the bad things aside, you don't mess with somebody's food. I don't care what they did. You don't mess with somebody's food, okay? Food is holy, especially a charcuterie board. Those things are expensive, man. And it was a gift. It was a reward that she got for winning head of household, and she was specifically saving it for when she was no longer a have-not, and Brooklyn got into it, did not deserve to eat it. And the fact that, and this is kind of spoilers because I'm specifically talking about episode 17, so Wednesday's episode, not Thursday's, but the fact that when Brooklyn got evicted and Angela said in her goodbye message, like, you ate my charcuterie board, I'm still mad about that, and Brooklyn said, well, it was gonna go bad. No, it wasn't, Brooklyn. You knew exactly what you're doing, and it was that, I was already starting to, like not like her for things that she was saying and doing, but that right there, I was done. I was like, get her out of the house. She has no respect for anybody. She is rude. And yeah, you can say the same thing about Angela, but Angela didn't eat somebody else's food as far as I know. So anyway, I don't understand why Angela wasn't like fighting her about that or wasn't like making a big deal about it. I think Angela's really, really trying to lay low, but ma'am, fight for your food. The doggy dog world of this Big Brother house. Food is serious. Fight for, I was more shocked almost that like she didn't hardly say anything. She just sat there and watched her eat, and she said something like, oh, my charcuterie meat. And that's all she said as far as we know. Like, you didn't say anything. I would have yanked it out of her hands and been like, get your disgusting grubby paws off my food. I didn't give you permission to touch this. That's what I would have been like. Anyway, okay, so other notes about episode 17. I didn't realize that the hide and go veto competition has been gone for so long. It's one of those things that I didn't really think about. It is absolutely a staple of Big Brother, but it's one of those competitions that I also don't like because people intentionally get nasty about it. They intentionally mess up the house, and it's just like, I nobody has any respect for anybody in this competition. So I was like, hopefully they won't trash the house. But you know, we had Brooklyn, who was intentionally messing up people's clothes, like, you like your clothes, but I'm gonna mess it up. Well, you know what? That just proves how awful you are. Like, don't get into somebody's stuff and mess it up. That's just rude. And then, you know, later it caused this whole issue where, what's his name? Tucker thought that Quinn was getting into his stuff, and Brooklyn's like laughing, like, that was me. Like, geez. Let's see. Mad respect to Joseph, who did not want to rummage through clothes and was respecting people's stuff. Like, he didn't want to put his memory card in people's stuff. He didn't want to mess up people's stuff. Like, honest respect that he just stayed out of people's things. Like, you know what, in this competition where everybody else is getting into everybody else's stuff, I respect him for that. Like, I just, yeah. And then I was like, what is with people hiding all the memory cards in garment bags and clothes? Like, there are so many places you can hide these things in the house, and you choose to hide your memory card in almost everybody hid their memory cards in someone's clothes. Like, what the heck, man? Come up with something better. Be a little bit more creative. But, and then, of course, Tucker wins again. Like, yeah, I love how Tucker is playing this game. For the most part. I mean, there's some things that he does that I'm not a fan of, but, and yeah, he is a fantastic player. He's gone from like being a, like just low key to like being this huge, big threat. And, I'm just tired of him winning. I'm tired of him winning competitions. Like, I would like to see somebody else win because it's like, oh, Tucker won again. Tucker saving Quinn after making all of those alliances public knowledge and lasting them was fantastic. I mad respect for that. I'm not happy Quinn was saved necessarily because I'm ready to see him get out of the house because he's just annoying. But Tucker talking about all these alliances, making a public knowledge, and then choosing to save Quinn, it was just like, I respect that. Okay. Anyway, that is it for episode 17. Thank you guys so much. I know it was a little bit late, but the school year just started, so I'm trying to adjust to working all day again and getting back on like this busy after-school schedule I have, and then also watching these episodes and then also making these. So I will see you guys soon. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think of this episode. Let me know what your stance is on Brooklyn eating Angela's charcuterie board. And that's it for me today. Bye.